Hi guys, and welcome to the next video. This video is practical again, and now it's more focused on more advanced social engineering attacks, more advanced beef attacks. I'm going to explain what's a beef, how can you use that, what benefits you can get, and when to use that. So basically, beef is a framework for cross-site scripting and social engineering attacks. It can implement really strong social engineering attacks. They all depend on your creativity, they all depend on your logic, they just depend on your thinking. And the better creativity, the better the attacks, so the better chance of success. Therefore, beef is just an amazing framework. It's mainly focused on that, and it works really simple. So beef actually, therefore, beef generates a hooking script where you can actually paste that script into some of your pages. And for example, one good example of attack is creating a page that can be like a blog or can be something like a long video or interesting thing. So when people come there, they're gonna stay and be sustained. So there, from when they actually visit your infected page, their browser gets infected because inside you have a malicious JavaScript there, and therefore this JavaScript infects their browser, and their browser starts to actually be vulnerable to some kind of attacks made by you. And while they're on that same page, you can start and shoot in exploits, shoot in attacks for credentials, shoot in attacks for downloading payloads, and many more stuff, and you're gonna see that in action. So this is how it works. It's really simple. It generates a scripting, which is actually a hooking. It's hooking your browser. After hooked, your browser is vulnerable to few attacks unless it's on that specific page. So it's good practice to choose a page who can be sustained, not with many buttons, because buttons mean refresh or actually forward to a new page, and that and the new page you get forward wouldn't be the same page and wouldn't be infected. So if they, for example, go to a next page, they're gonna go to the next original page, and therefore they're gonna go and skip the infection procedure. So now beef is pre-installed in Kali as always, but you can easily install it from GitHub. Just search for beef-xs downloads, and therefore you should get the result. It's really easy to install, and there are instructions. So to run beef, just type beef.xss start. This is going to generate and start our web UI and our hooking script. And this is the example, the pattern of the hooking script. So for example, it can be like this is happening because I didn't set up my default browser. Now we can start and copy our URL, copy that, just open a Firefox, and now give it a time to load. Just paste that, the URL of the beef framework, so beef login. And keep in mind that all the attacks implemented here can be used for external attacks, but you can actually use different IPs, like external IP, and you have to verify that your firewall can actually allow all the connections. So here we have offline browsers because we've already hooked the browser. And now this is the basic beef menu, beef interface. Here we have online browsers that are currently infected right now. And we have the offline ones that were infected in the past. So here we're gonna close that. Here we have logs, and this is the basic beef information table here. We have the basic and requester here. Yeah, so these are like a manager of hosts. And so now it's time to actually use our pattern in order to generate a page. And actually we're gonna use a page generated from the social engineering attack before to actually implement our beef hooking script. So now here, open a terminal, clear that. Open tmux. Now, it's time to actually navigate to our patch directory. So cd var www.html, and therefore we have index.html. I've removed the pause.php file and removed the log file since we no longer need them, but the index.html is the same. So now here we can actually use vim to open that file, and this is like the code of our page. As you can see, this is the code for our page, and somewhere in that code here I've type it in the bottom. Here you can actually paste that your IP, the port, and the hook.js. Like you can see that information here. So it type beef dash access, and you're going to see the URL here, for example that, and you just need to specify the correct IP address. So you just copy that, paste it here, and just specify your IP address. That's all you have to do, and nothing more. And when you do that, you're going to now inject a script into your page, and when someone connects to your page, they're going to actually get hooked by BEEF framework. So they're not going to see anything, but you're going to see everything about it. So let's just show that in action. So remove Vim, so quit. And now it's time to run Apache server. So service Apache to start. Okay, now we're ready to go. And we go to Windows machine here, open Firefox, and type like 192.168.1.10. And as you can see, we've prompted it with a Facebook login page, but as I said, the page can be anything, and it's better to be page with some kind of article, some kind to be sustained and without any kind of buttons, because any button can lead to a new page. That means that our infection is over. So now if we actually go to our Kali machine, to our BEEF UI, we're gonna see that online browsers has already one browser here. We can actually see and specify all we can see about that browser. So now he's currently online at that page, and he's using Mozilla browser language Bulgarian plugin. Okay, so we have even the window size, which is great. We have no flash, no VBScript, and as you can see, we can extract very much information about the target. We can even get if he has quick time, real player, flash player. So if you have flash player, we can go for flash player like attacks. We can disable information that can lead to potential social engineering attacks. As you can see, he's not having a flash player, so we can go for like, you are missing flash player, please install it. Or if he has flash player, we can go for like, your flash player has been outdated and you have to update and validate. And therefore, when downloading our flash, he's gonna be infected, and actually his machine is gonna infect. Now here we have page title, we're going to Facebook, this is our page, this is the page URL when we have actually infected our browser. We have the host, the cookie, and therefore we have the host IP, the date, the operation system, the CPU are unknown. We have even the screen size of that machine. So we have many things here under the current browser. Now these are the details, we have the log files, and as you can see, become online. Okay, so comments. So this is where the magic happens. As you can see, we have some kind of explorer of basically commands that we can reuse. And for example, for browser, we can use like the webcam one. So everything which is green can be actually used. We can use the webcam one, we can use the detect QuickTime. For example, we just run that and see what happens. So now when we click execute, the comment appeared here. And when we click that comment, we have the output here. So as you can see, the comment turned. So this is some kind of a log file. And if you run another comment, there's gonna be another output. So this is like a log file for every specific comment. And there is the output for that comment. So as you can see, QuickTime, no. Here we have like a LastPass, not in use or not installed. So no. And therefore, we can use many attacks, and it's actually good to use the green one, because they are most likely to be actually used or successful. Now we can actually get cookie, run many attacks, like execute. Now we should get the cookie. Some kind of attacks need some time. As you can see, now we have the cookie itself. If you go here to the HTML, now we should get the HTML as well. So some kind of attacks are slower than others. Now here we have like Chrome extensions, we have debug, we have some testing, we have exploits. So we can go for many kind of exploits. Let's go for shell shock, and now let's go to the target, which is basically offline browser. Why? I'm here. Okay, so here we can go like and try some different kind of exploits. Let's for example specify our target 216.1.11. You need to specify the IP, so run. Okay. But he's not using it, so this command actually is not going to work. But let's say we have like cmd.exe, so run. Now see the second output. No output for now. Okay, just wait a little bit. See what happens. As you can see, we have different types of attacks. We have like Jenkins. We have many, many kinds of attacks. We have here beef bind. We have like camera exploits. We have localhost. We have Java apps here, router, switch, cross-site scripting attacks. And therefore, so just minimize that. Therefore, hosts, detect bin defender, detect Google desktop, detect many machines. So if we go to detect virtual machines, let's see what that can output us. Okay, so not virtualized. Okay, so good, because this is basically the guest of my virtual machine. We have even Metasploit module here. We have some kind of miss here, like for example, iframe one, iframe sniffers, IBM nodes, amazing. We have really a lot of things to play around, a lot of things to work with. Let's see if we can detect social networks. So execute. Okay, so we have persistence, so we can get a main in the browser attack here. Okay, so this module, there is a brief description about every module here. So this module will use a main in the browser attack to ensure that beef hook will stay until user leaves the domain, manually changing the URL bar. So okay, execute. Now we are going to get more persistent. Okay, browser hooked. Now I think if we actually specify the new domain, we're gonna be actually unhooked. But if we have multiple pages on the same domain, like for example the same IP, we are not going to get unhooked. You're gonna go and play around with all that kind of options, but as you can see, there's even a persistent one. Therefore, we have in beep, we have a prompt user, we have even here persistence. Yeah, a beep hook into phones gaps index HTML, and this for iPhones only. Now here we can prompt user, we can upload even a file. So we can actually execute furthermore that file. And as you can see, there are really many, many stuff to play around. And here we have the actual social engineering, but before that, see if it found any social networks. So Gmail, not authenticated, Twitter, no. And no, okay, so we have social engineering attacks. Let's see what we have here. And we have like Google phishing, we have like pretty tips, we have main user attacks. So let's see and use that. So this plugin uses images tag, okay, to log out the Google or Gmail. Okay, so let's just run that. Now we have like, and just run that like so it was. Okay, so, okay, now just execute that. Let's see what happens. Go to Windows machine. And as you can see, now we've prompted with a login about Gmail. And as you can see, this is quite dangerous and quite pretty good looking and pretty good made. And when we type something here, now we get redirected to our official Gmail page. And therefore, if we actually go to our Gallery machine and see the output, we get username, we get the password. So this amazing tool of Gallery Gmails. This is just amazing too. We have fake notification bars. Let's go for Firefox, because we've enumerated there is a Firefox. So just execute that. Let's see what happened there. Now we need to start plugins, and therefore how you can actually inject payloads, how you can actually start hacking that machine. And since you inject the browser, there is a really good stuff about how, what can you do, what attacks can you use. So here we have even the PowerShell module. And this tricks the user into opening and allowing the execution of HTML application. Okay, so we can even run shell commands. We can use PowerShell commands and actually provoking the user into executing a PowerShell. There is a description about every module here. So there are really a lot of modules here. And since we infect the user's browser, we can do completely anything with it. Execute shells, execute payloads, with that, and that depends on our social engineering attacks. You need to know how to trick the user, you need to know what to present the user, you need to know how to actually lie the user into steal his information. So as you can see, technical error, you will not have any problem, but the key thing here is to actually learn how to hack people. And this is what is hard. And as you can see, we have a social engineering and exploit modules, we have a lot of them. So you can play around with it and see what's happening over there. So this is how the beef works, this is how it manages actually the process, it how it is basically working. And it's a really good framework, as I said before. It's really simple to use that. There are actually many menus and options here to actually, there is even a shell. We can use run commands here. So just beef is an amazing framework for hacking, amazing framework for browser hacking. It can get persistence, and it can get even everything that you need from the current browser or current target. But as I said, you need to think like a hacker, you need to think like a psychologist. So thank you everyone for watching. This is how Beef works, and see you in the next video.